Welcome to Animator. This is Fredo. We are going to see how to create a scaling movement. So let's start Animator and let's create a new movement. We select an object, select the scaling tool. As you can see, for those familiar with the SketchUp scaling tools, you retrieve the handles. Every time you over handle, you see the corresponding pivot. Here in the palette, you have buttons indicating the scaling factors as well as the dimension of the selected object. And here, these three small buttons are for the state of the modifiers, the center, the free direction for some handles, like these ones or these ones, and enabling or disabling inference. Okay. You have, of course, equivalent keys, Control, Shift, and Alt. For this modifier, we will see that in a moment. So you can simply drag a handle. Okay. Alternatively, you can click, move, and click again. And here you play the animation, and the object is scaling. You can, of course, cumulate scaling. So let's create a second animation and take this object, which is within the big one, scale it. Let's say like this. I press Control to scale it by the center. And if I save and now play the two animation, let's play it together. This one a little bit longer. You see that they can be combined. Now let's look into the options of the tool. So let's create a new movement. Select this object. So first, you can scale the object interactively. So the object is deformed as you move the handle. It's not always convenient, and therefore I have introduced a wireframe mode. So let's reset. You can reset the scaling by clicking the button or pressing Escape. For example, if I want, by dragging, reduce the X direction by 2, that's very difficult. So here you have the wireframe mode. You can click here, and if now you move, the object remains the same, but it's a wireframe showing the deformation. You can use inference, so press Alt to toggle it, and for example, here you can easily scale the object half of this dimension in X. You have a free modifier, so I reset the scaling. So the first one is you are probably familiar with is by the center versus by an extremity handle. So here the handle is on the other side. If I press Control, I get it by the center. Unlike SketchUp, and this is true for all modifier, you don't need to keep control depressed. You just press it, release it, and you toggle between the two modes. Second modifier, so let me reset. The second modifier is a multiple direction. When you select a corner handle, for example, you normally have a uniform scaling in X, Y, and Z. So you have only one scale factor. So here you scale uniformly. You can force by pressing Shift or this button scaling in any direction. This also exists in the scaling tool of SketchUp. So here you can modify. If you press Shift, you force the direction. Here you are free again. The last modifier is inference. So I don't know if it's frequently used, but if you use the inference, you can set the scaling box by element in the model. Here, just press Alt to disable and or to enable. Okay. By the way, if you play the animation, you see here an example of negative scales. That is, you actually mirror the object by the plane of the object. So you see. We have seen how to design a scaling movement by dragging a handle. Let's see how we can design it and specify the factors and dimension by value. So I take the movement, I reset it. So in the initial state, the scaling is by default by the center. You can modify the scaling factor by typing values. In the VCB, the convention is that depending on what is shown here, here you have the three factors, three. You type them in order separated by space or semicolon. I don't use space because I don't use comma because comma is used as a decimal point in some countries like France. So if you type, for example, three only, it will apply to the X factor. If you type 3 space 1.5, it will apply to X and Y. If you want to specify only one factor, let's say Z, just type semicolon, semicolon, and for Z 4.5. Okay, and you see that only Z has been changed. You can same thing, set the dimension of the object. So the object is currently 699.89. If you want it to change to 4, you just type the value 4 meter. In the VCB, you apply the same logic with the order in X, Y, and Z, but you have to put the unit. Otherwise, it won't differentiate with the scaling factor. So if I want to change it to, let's say, the Y to 3.5 meter, so I skip X, 3.5, M for meter, and here it goes. For dimensions, you can use also the dimension dialog box, which you can call by pressing this dims button or pressing enter. So in this box you have the dimension, the increment of the dimension versus the original dimension, and the corresponding scaling factor. So you can change any of these values and it will change the others. Usually this box is used to increment, to add increment. Let's reset. You want, for example, to add 2 meters in the X direction. So you add 2 and you see that now the dimension is 4.3 coming from 2.3. You can set the dimension to 0. So let's reset this and take this handle and type 0. So you get a very thin plate. One utilization of the zero scaling is to simulate the appearance of a shape. So let's place this animation. You see that I start from a thin plate, and if I place the animation, you get actually a shape of a terrain. Okay, so let's see how we do that. So let's start again. So I create first a scaling. So select this direction, put a zero scale. So you get a thin plate, and I save. Now the trick is that you reduce the duration to 0. So the animation goes directly to the final state, which is a thin plate, and you insert the same scaling, except you reverse it. Now if you play the animation, you get this effect. Finally, if you specify the scaling by value, it's still important to specify the pivot and the moving handle. So let's reset. So here, if you want to specify the pivot and scaling handle, so double click on the handle. So now it's frozen, and therefore you can freely decide to change the value by the VCB or the palette buttons. Let's reset. Here I freeze this one, or I freeze this one. I can set multiple directions, so, and also change the center. Okay, you see that this one is frozen. Now, what happens if you select several objects? So let's take this object. I press Control to go in a temporary selection mode. I have now the two objects. They will be scaled independently, but by the same factor. That's as simple as that. Of course, the modifier will apply to both. If you over one object, you see the dimension here, 580 for this object, whereas if you over another object, the dimension are updated. Finally, you can combine the scaling tool with other movement. So let's scale this by the center, big. Save, and now let's create a path movement. So selecting this object, putting it on this path. So let's put it on the path itself. If I play the animation, you see that the object follows the path while growing. You can, of course, put the scaling at any given point in the timeline. You can also do the reverse scaling. So take this scaling, a sequence, add it, and for example, reverse it. So if you play now the animation, the object will grow and then will shrink while moving along the path. I think that's all for the scaling tool. Thank you very much for your attention and enjoy your SketchUp.